Due to COVID-19, many libraries are physically closed. Reading and research have gone online. And for those who have access to university libraries, this isn't so different. They can still access academic texts online through their library subscriptions. But for the rest of us, what do we do? Well, there are online places that you can go to find academic texts. And one of my favorite is JSTOR. Today, I'm going to show you what JSTOR is and how you can use it to find academic articles for your papers. Hey, I'm Suzanne Davis, an academic writing tutor and coach, and I help students excel at the writing they need to do to succeed in high school, college, and graduate school. So I have examined a lot of the resources and tools that benefit people with academic writing. And so if this type of information is helpful to you, then I would love for you to subscribe to my YouTube channel here. Now, let's get into JSTOR. JSTOR is an index that you can search for information about all different types of topics. It covers 75 different disciplines. And now it's really exciting because JSTOR is doing this super special thing during the COVID-19 crisis, and they're letting individuals search for articles and download up to 100 articles from now until June 30th, 2020. So let's take a look at how to use JSTOR. Okay, so you will find JSTOR at jstor.org. If you take a look at the homepage, you'll see that you can do a basic search right from the homepage. And I'm going to pretend that I am a student doing a paper on the novel Frankenstein, and in particular, the character of the monster. So I'm going to start the way a lot of students start, which is just by looking up the title of the book. And you'll see that when I do this, I have a lot of results. I can narrow this down by author title and the publication name and try and search that way. Okay, so now you'll see that it says 13,742 search results, which is way too many. I can refine my search results this way. I could also try again with a basic search and add the term monster. I always start off doing an advanced search. I find that this helps me to make sure that I'm finding things that are in more recent years and that I'm searching the exact types of sources I'm looking for. So here I'm including not just the book, but I also want the article to have the word monster. I can add a search box and start to add more. You can look at this by access type, all content and content I can access. All content would give me information like a listing of other sources, but I wouldn't be able to look at it right here. I'd have to go somewhere else. So I want to search for content I can access. I'm narrowing this down to journal articles right now, but I could also check any of these. I'm also going to narrow this down by my native language, English. And another thing that I like to do is make sure that a lot of the articles I have are from more recent years. With literature, you can basically open it up a little bit more because there's all kinds of critical analysis that have been done on Frankenstein. Okay, I'm going to start searching for articles between 2010 and 2020. If I knew the journal or book title that I was looking for, I would add that. If I knew an ISBN, I could add that. I can also look at narrowing this down by discipline. So there are, I believe, 75 different disciplines listed here on JSTOR. You'll see all different kinds of topics from anthropology, aquatic sciences, astronomy, botany and plant sciences, criminology, all different types of subjects that you can look for. Because I'm looking at literature, I'm going to select the topic, language and literature, and they have 434 titles in that field, and search. And now you'll see that I actually have less results. I only have 2006 to search through. And I would start going through this, looking at all of the different headlines and start to see if I find anything that is relevant. Some of these would be off topic for me, but because it's only 206, I would read through it for a little while. And you can cite this item. So what's really neat is that JSTOR shows you how to do citations in MLA, APA, and Chicago. You can copy the text and then post it right into your own document. So this makes doing your bibliography 10 times easier. You can also export it in different things. All right, and you could click on this and start reading and annotating the PDF. Sometimes it has it that you'll only be able to read it online. And one of the things I recommend is that you save the articles that you find relevant so that it's easier for you to go back to them, especially if you've printed something out and you've lost what you printed out. You'll also find there's some really cool tools here. One that I like is Text Analyzer. And I've just been playing around with this for a little while. I don't know if it will last. It's in beta form. And it's something that I would not use as my only way of trying to find relevant sources, but I do think it's fun to play with and see what you can come up with. So what you would do is upload an article or a source in here, and the text analyzer looks at that text and reads up different topics and then makes suggestions for other articles that may be relevant. I'm going to upload this article toward an Irish Gothic author. I love Gothic literature, so it's a huge passion of mine. And now this is just taking a moment to analyze the text. And it came up with some different recommendations. All right, so you'll see that you can, again, look at different filters. It's found different terms in the article. So it's been looking at, in these articles, those same terms that would come up. Again, you can cite it, save it, download the PDF. And so I recommend that you just try this, see if it works for you. Okay, and the final thing that I want to point out about JSTOR is that they are doing something super special for people who don't have access to a university library. Right now, because of that and COVID-19 making it really hard to get all kinds of articles online, they have made it so that you can look up and save, download 100 articles for free up until June 30th, 2020. So if you're writing a research paper right now, this is the perfect time to check out JSTOR. Now that you've seen how to do research on JSTOR, please let me know in the comments below how you could use JSTOR for your own research papers and projects that you have. And if you like this video, then please like this video and subscribe to my channel so that you can get more tips, tutorials, and advice on how to advance your academic writing. Cheers.